Alrighty, today we have what's called a community septic system that we're looking at. They're not super common in the area, but you do come across them from time to time. So today we're gonna kind of dive into what they look like, where you can usually find them, and why they exist. If you like content like this, please go ahead and feel free to subscribe as I will have more content posted daily. All right, let's dive into it. So you're buying a house. You see one of these bad boys on the side of the home. Generally, you'll see the big old red light and this big white box on the side of the house, generally closest to the driveway. It's almost always gonna be right in front of the garage door, as we can see right over there. The reason they wanna put this right in front of the garage door or by the driveway is so you, as a homeowner, can see and hear when something's going wrong, right? This is designed so when the pump in the pump chamber is not working and the water level rises, this goes off and alerts you to call this number right here. Now, you'll also see this style of alarm box on a regular private sewage system, right? But how we know this is a public sewer is you can see the county name right there. So this is gonna be their property to work with. So you're gonna see that there's a lock right over here. You're not allowed to mess with that, right? If you have issues, you need to call the county specifically to address whatever's going on, right? A lot of times you'll see either an HOA will be the one who addresses any of these issues as far as payment. Sometimes the county will bill you directly. So if you ever are purchasing a house or don't know how the payment process, it's best to reach out to the health department and they'll tell you, or to the HOA, and they should be able to give you an idea of what's going on. If the home's already existed for a while, the homeowner should already know exactly what the process is, who they're paying, and when they pay it, so that way you, when you take over the property, know what you're supposed to do. So again, this alarm box is designed to let you know, hey, there's a problem, you need to call somebody to get it addressed. Again, usually it's a failure in the pump. So hopefully you never have to hear this alarm go off, but it exists for a reason. On a private septic system, it will do the exact same thing, except for you'll be able to open that box to silence the alarm and then also make it to where any contractor you choose can come to fix the issue. So let's go ahead and take a look at the sewer line itself. Because we're on a community septic, we're gonna have a traditional sewer line, right? So you're gonna have your 4-inch Schedule 40 PVC that runs out of the house with the snake lines all the way up to a pump chamber. The reason you're gonna end up having something like this on your property is either A, you have bad soil, bad lot, you have a lot of conservation area around the lot, or the HOA and the developer of the property decided that they wanted to go ahead and make it to where this is a benefit to the homeowner. So that way it's considered public sewer and that you don't have to necessarily worry about the same kind of ramifications that you get with the septic system. So when you have your sewer line, you're gonna have pipes like this in the yard. This particular property has three of them. We have one right by the foundation. We have one right in the middle of the yard. And then we're gonna have one a little bit further up towards the pump chamber. The reason these pipes exist is so if you get a clog between the home and the tank, sometimes your snake can't make it all the way to the pump chamber. So every 75 foot or so, you're gonna have one of these bad boys. And this is just to make it to where you can dislodge whatever's going on without having to go in the home, right? So the one by the foundation, so that way if something gets stuck in between here and the house, you can go from the foundation wall out to here. If it's between here and the other one, you can go from here to over there, all the way up until you get to the pump chamber, right? Most homes are gonna have those. Every single house should have one, but if you're before the 1980s in our area, it's a little bit far and few between when you actually see them. So the water will progress with the solids through the sewer pipe, just like you would normally see in any other normal public sewer line. Same thing with the septic system, except for we're gonna come up to this large chamber over here. So if you're driving around a neighborhood and you start to notice that a lot of the houses have this in front of it, that's going to be your first indicator that maybe they have a community septic system. So what is a community septic system? Community septic system is basically going to be a large version of a normal septic system, except for it's going to service several homes. In this particular neighborhood, there's about 20 houses. So each of those houses is going to have the sewer line push the water over to here. There's going to be a pump in here that will pump it to a large field to where the drain fields are. So where a normal septic system for a house of this size would probably be about 1500 gallons, two chamber with three or so drain fields, this is going to have probably 15 to 30 drain fields in a large field. if you're buying a home that you believe to be on community septic, if you start walking around, you'll usually see somewhere in the neighborhood a large field that kind of looks like you'd play soccer or something on. That's generally where it's going to be, right? Don't have to worry about any kind of surfacing sewage or anything crazy like that. The county is going to be responsible to make sure that they're checking it and keeping on top of it. But that's usually what they're going to do to address it. So this little guy right here is going to be just like you would see on any other public sewer line. And like the snake lines that we saw a moment ago, this is designed to dislodge any clogs between. Inside of here, you're going to see a concrete box, just like you'd see for a normal septic tank, except for there's going to be a pump inside of there that grinds up that sewage water, pumps it up and into the main. Now, it is mechanical. So one day those pumps are going to eventually fail on you. And then that's where that alarm box comes into play, right? If the pump fails, the alarm goes off, you now know I need to make a phone call to get this addressed. And then the county is usually pretty good about coming out same day to fix whatever went wrong with the pump, whether it be a float issue, an electrical issue, or mechanical issue such as the pump. Now, the high water alarm inside of here will not let you know when you have a clog in between the tank or in between this and the house. So if you start to notice an issue with slow drain, or if you start getting some kind of swampiness near one of those cleanouts, let's just say that maybe one of the lids is not on all the way, you might actually have a clog and it may not be the pump's issue. So the county would not address that. That would be a you problem and you'd have to hire your own contractor to dislodge or clean the sewer line, right? I usually recommend to treat sewer systems just like you would with public or with septic systems. Don't put in feminine products. Don't put in flushable wipes, cigarettes, condoms, rubber ducks, none of that stuff. Greases and all sorts of like food particulates from like a garbage disposal that can get in there and can cause excessive buildup. That excessive buildup can eventually lead to a clog, right? If you're going to do that regardless, you should consider getting your sewer line jetted every few years, just to make sure you blast all of that debris out of the line and into the pump chamber to get it out of your area, right? What jetting is basically power washing the pipe. You'll generally see this done on pipes that have clogs in it or root intrusion or debris buildup, especially in like cast iron pipes. This is all gonna be PVC though, so as long as you're not putting stuff down there that doesn't belong down there, you should be perfectly fine. Now, where do I usually see this style of system? I'll generally only see it in a few neighborhoods in Howard County, right? So over by the Glen Elg area, Clarksville, we'll see it in some parts of Woodbine. And then we will also sometimes see it over in Brighton, Ten Oaks area, right? Baltimore County area, you'll generally see this closer to like Essex, Middle River, White Marsh. You will not generally see this in Montgomery County, Frederick County, Carroll County, or Anne Arundel County. It's a little bit far and few between. It does probably exist. It's just not super common, right? I hope that if you guys are purchasing a home and you believe that it's on a septic system, you have it inspected to verify that no, it is, or yes, it is not. If you don't know, it's always best to call the county. The county will have some kind of paperwork somewhere to let you know, like, yes, we're in charge of taking care of this, or nope, this is a private system. This is something that you have to maintain. Don't be afraid of a community septic system. It's kind of that in-between situation between public sewer and private sewer. There's just a little bit more that you have to do compared to a normal public sewer. Public sewer, in general, you just kind of let it sit, do its thing, pay the county, you're no problem, you're good to go. This one, if it fails or if something's going on, you have to get a little bit more involved to address whatever the situation would be. But once the water reaches here, it's usually the county's problem, not your problem. So I hope that this helps to bring a little bit of clarity into what a community septic system is. If you enjoy content like this, I post daily on the World of Well and Septic. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment below as I try to get to all of my viewers' questions. If you want me to cover a specific topic, feel free to leave a suggestion and I will see if I can find some footage somewhere to kind of discuss and go through whatever your question may be. Till next time.